drive the point home. That was the point that was supposed to be made.
Are we still leasing lot?
But do we, I mean, the truck's not locked.
Well, we do, because, you know, because young girls shouldn't find, like, used things on their sneakers in the morning. Do you know what I mean? From previous night's activities, and I know personally people that that has happened to. And so I just feel like it needs to be locked. You know? That seems to be the place, and that would be an interesting question for the groundskeepers, because I think they're the ones that were finding all this stuff too. Is, are they finding the same stuff at the track that they were finding at the football field? You know, the football field was a little more centrally located, it was by the school, the track is more.
In my time here, from what I've heard from my grounds guys, more of that type of stuff, up at the track, but up at the track, yes. More secluded. We also, there's no secret here, the fence is not 100% secure all the way around. There are issues with that fence. So there are other access points other than just walk down.
Have you ever considered any, I know this sounds crazy, you know, just like garden lighting, like very low lighting around the track area? I mean, it's so dark up there. So you could put in lighting that's not anywhere offensive to the neighbors, but it would be something that would kind of just give a little bit of light in there. And it might actually deter people from going in there. Like small garden lights, you know what I'm talking about?
Or a motion light. Why couldn't a motion light go on these? To alert them that you're being watched. I mean, at the A field, we have really great cameras now, correct? To stop, to catch activity on the A field, right?
Correct. There are cameras that point at the softball field, the track, and also at the baseball field / bus lot. That one moves back and forth. Same night vision capabilities.
But at the A field property, I'm saying, if you're saying girls are stepping on stuff at the A field, don't our cameras pick that up? Or you're just looking if there's an incident on our cameras?
If something is brought to my attention.
Then you can look it up and
correct.
See who was there the night before.
Up to 90 days.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
And a motion light up at the track, would that be possible? I mean, is that even needed? I mean, are we having this conversation just to prolong the security conversation and adding things to our list, or?
Anything's possible up there. It would all depend on where we're looking.
I guess I want people to know where I'm coming from is I agree there has to be a starting point, but I also agree, you know, do we have a liability of open fields? That's all I'm saying. I don't know what the answer is,
well,
and I don't know what the cost associated with that is. It seems like you're darned if you do, darned if you don't, type of thing. I'd rather try to say all the don'ts. I don't want anything.
We also, though, would be required, I think, at this point, having this discussion, like, just thinking, like, don't we have to have a sign up that says it's under surveillance?
We have signage up.
We do.
There's one up at the truck.
There is some.
Yeah, right by the field house.
Yep.
Do you have it by all the little holes?
No.
We won't be able to see through it. I just think we should really consider what our school policy is with. If something were to happen at 10 o'clock at night, whether it's a track, whether it's a field, I don't care where it is. I think we should have something in place that says, hey, this is what we're about, you know, these are hours of operation. I have to lock my dumpsters up at night so people don't go and scrap the metal and then I'm liable for it. You know, what is our liability?
So isn't that a question for Jeff Litz?
What's that?
Isn't that a question for Jeff? Just
I,
what is our liability? And then your proposal is you would like to have signs at the fields.
At least as a starting point, you say, like, listen, you know, you're not supposed to be here.
I agree.
You know?
What was, Jennifer, can you think of what that, what we do, because we don't have any of you, is going to send it out to the patients to the facilities. I want to, though, come back to where are we with this, because I think Mike's still able to have an idea with, if we're moving forward with this, if not, if we're tabling this until August, that's fine. But I don't want to lose sight of the conversation in terms of what our actions against trying to be mindful of what we need to do this. If you want to table this until August, we can find out the liability, we can communicate with you through email, reports.
Can we make a decision separate on the elevators and the fields, or do they actually combine?
No, that's why I broke them out separately, for consideration on both.
The elevator, we should do, it's, it costs our $7,000 in the last 3 years, just to fix it. Even so, major keys, I would say absolutely.
No, we just said you have to fix them, that's why they, assuming that they have to down, they don't have to use their keys.
We get a, we use Kencor, a company from the, they, we.
Key only breaks in there?
No, what happens is inside the mechanism, if the kids crank down on it too much, the mechanism's inside.
Got it.
They don't make it like.
And then it has, it jams or something, yes, right.
Correct.
Right.
Correct, and sometimes, and it varies, sometimes it makes it inoperable, sometimes it makes it to the point where it's just going up and down on its own, so.
But I think a lot of temporary times where if the elevators for, you know, 6 weeks for questions or something, so then you can follow on and off, and if you call it, you can keep that.
90% of the time, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I agree with you on that, and maybe we can do, table the gate, football gate, but back at the fundraisers.
Can we ask about that conversation there?
I think this should take priority over.
I'm happy to have a conversation.
You know, it's a cost to the district.
So what I hear is you're tabling the discussion for the locking mechanism with a recommendation and request, actually, for Mike to talk with the fundraisers about the cost of the locking mechanism. The permission to move forward, we're gonna also, we're gonna have to talk about what procedures you want for June and July in regard to fence gates. So you need to be clear about that you're wanting them to be locked during the summer. Whereas we've been discussing that other fields are open, I wonder what your label was.
I don't want them to be locked, we say locked during the summer, not.
So I'm just, I would be very clear about what your expectation is for the gates in terms of how they should be handled. Do you want them, I mean, if it means that Mike is locking them and unlocking them, so be it. But I want to know what your wish is for the summer, because it's clear, or Mike said there are times where they are not locked, and I want to know.
And what I would like to see personally is all our gates being locked at appropriate time. Just to protect the school. I don't want to lock it today by any means, but, you know, and if you miss a couple nights, you miss a couple nights, but at least we sent the residents that, you know, someone's going up there, you know, whether they're in our school district or someone else's, hey, they lock this stuff up. Some nights I'm gonna lock my car door as well, but 95% of the time it's locked and locked. But I think, and I just want to be very clear, I'm not just looking at it as a football, looking at it as like school property. Like, you know, we're talking about stuff that's going on at the track. I just couldn't live with, you know, getting the whole thing to happen. And I just think, you know, signs and then some sort of protection is what I'm looking for.
So gates will not be locked during the day, gates will be locked at night, not just the football field, and we will get costs for signage and put that out. And do we have the permission to move forward with signage costs? We can do that through.
I'm for it, yeah, is everybody else against that?
It's not, actually, we could actually probably get that on the agenda for the meeting.
Can we have a match of boroughs, maybe uniform it, kind of like all kind of tie it in?
Not that we have the next term together.
Okay.
We can address that. All right, so you're gonna move on getting costs for signage, the first step, we'll try and get that
cost is expensive for the gates, so I am asking the committee, like, what is the thought of splitting it with fundraisers? Like, is that palatable to our board, or that we ask them to cost cover the $11,000 additional dollars of trying to get all the way to Girard? Do you know what I mean? Like, are we willing to work with them? Just throw it out.
I don't know what the landscaping costs are.
I don't know how much money's left, you know.
You know, I didn't know there was.
Could be significant.
Ah, really?
I mean, I don't, you know, again, I haven't been there a couple of weeks in the field to see what's going on, whether, but I think, to me, security is most important, and I don't know what that means, I don't know what that number is, but to me, that is more important than a matter of, landscaping.
So, just so I'm clear, we're talking football fence, and the track gate that leads up to the path, and all the other gates, obviously.
Yeah, I think that would make sense, I mean, I don't.
I just want to be clear.
That's what I was looking for.
You just add, so you're talking about mechanical or touch and feel?
Locking and not, I'm talking locking and not, I'm talking locking, I just want to make sure I got game plan.
I don't know, do it until it's shut.
Oh, they shut, they shut. Let's get them locked, one way or the other. Okay, couple more items on this list, and then we're gonna go down to new business, and I'm gonna complete it. Oh, the only two others was walk-in freezer, which, as far as I know, unless something changed, will be on the agenda for Monday's meeting, for approval, and we're gonna get that moving for Diane, get that installed. Room is ready. The old chiller room is ready, and we've done several different measurements, and I think we got that $73,000 is a firm cost. So I think initially it was $75,000. Got a couple down with that. So every dollar counts, right, Lord? So, classroom painting. This is something we discussed at the last committee meeting. Six rooms here at the high school, the worst of the worst. Which is a not to exceed number of $12,000. We're hoping to get them taken care of this.
No, we're not. We will.
Only six.
We will.
There was only six.
Six.
He can just come back.
Well, we have a
plan. When we do this, he actually did a walkthrough of the to see the rooms. We need that facelift in the classrooms, understanding. This machine that I'm proposing takes off 8 to 12 layers of wax in one pass, which we have identified as a need within our custodial department simply because we have older sections of building district-wide, with the exception of West Reading, that in years past, and this is no knock on my predecessors, we just simply threw wax on top of wax to get a new sheen on and never really took it down. But now the floor program that I put in place, we are at the point where we need to strip these floors down and refinish them the proper way. Now, saying that stripping them by hand, so to speak, entails stripping solution and also literally at this point, flat shovels to shovel the amount of wax coming up. Not very efficient.
great use of man hours. So I'm proposing this machine is $7,500. Potentially could reduce, that will reduce overtime and man hours, and overall definitely reduce potential working conflicts. So that's my pitch. I think this would definitely benefit the summer cleaning schedule, and help make it go a little quicker. And with the summer programs expanding, which is a great thing, we definitely have shorter time periods. So just something for the board to consider. This machine can be at our doors next week. And I do apologize if I should have brought this up last month. Just kind of was a hectic month getting present together. CoStars, so it's already been bid out. Any questions? Floor stripping machine. Yes, we transport it the same way we transport our other machines. We rent a Penske truck for the day with a lift gate, bring it up on the lift gate and the truck, drive it. We rent a truck 3 times over the summer for one day as we move from school to school. Yep.
So how many rims do you think are so badly waxed that would need to be replaced? I mean, if we bought a refinisher last year,
yep,
ultimately you wouldn't need this stripper. If you're keeping your schedule on track and you're really just catching up with classrooms, maybe that will miss by...
I would say the majority of the district.
Really?
Yes. West Reading, not West Reading, the Hills and the high school. If you ever look at the floors and they have that kind of brown hue to it, that's just layers and layers of wax that are underneath it. And to get them down, it requires scraping and shoveling of that nature. Now, this machine can take up to eight coats of wax, but it can also take one. And if we get to the point where we're caught up, this can be used as another finishing machine that we bought last week. So it'd be, yeah.
Which is it to what?
Just process it.
How much is it to rent this room?
How much is it to rent it?
Can we rent the equipment? If you're saying we don't need to use it.
We could, but it would be getting used all summer, and I don't have the rental costs in front of me, but I can't imagine what it would be.
But is this something that has to be, so is this something that has to be done once a month to strip the floors?
No, this is summer and winter break and spring break is when we can get in. We do hallways.
Refurbishment.
That was bought as a replacement for the cafeteria, and I just don't want that to get confused. That machine was bought as a replacement for the cafeteria, but we also use it for summer cleaning.
Is that what we use on these floors here?
In the summer, yes.
Big.
But we use that refinished, the machine that we bought last week, every single day in the cafeteria. Every single day.
So you're clarifying.
I could basically say in overtime we heard somebody at 2 to 3 summers. That's off the top of my head, but we do work 10 hour, the floor guys do work sometimes 10 hour days or Saturdays just to keep up with getting the number of classrooms we need to get done and hallways and things of that nature to work around some of them. So I think it would be modestly 2 to 3 summers of return on. Correct. We would use it at the Hill, but not. The Hills is newer, so that wouldn't need it as quickly as they would.
And you're just clarifying that this shouldn't have been on the table last year instead of what we did.
Correct.
Right?
Last year was a replacement for a broken piece of equipment that lives in the cafeteria until the breaks, and then we use it for summer cleaning. This would be an addition to that. But this machine just strips wax instead. $7,500.
I think from a maintenance perspective, that's not a lot of money. And in San Diego business, and don't know how difficult it is to strip floors and how time consuming and dangerous with that break it is. From a workman's comp perspective, I think it makes sense. To rent anything is much more expensive than using it in summer every day.
that and the elevators is what I'm looking for, some direction. I think I got the elevators already, but
so we need to approve the machine.
I would go for it.
I mean, I don't, is that a price?
It's a CoStar price. We looked at two different machines. I've had my custodial pool person out and we demoed it and I think it was super expensive.
Maybe go faster.
Oh, definitely. This would be, taking, instead of them hand mopping, stripper on and shoveling it up, this would be a different process.
Can we ask them to just check on what it costs to rent it for the summer and if that price is, in this ballpark? Say, no, great, forward, then just go forward, whichever one makes more sense. But at least to investigate, right?
And the guys know how to use these machines, right?
Absolutely.
That way too, then, renting it for summer, it would be possible to do a change.
Potentially.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
One more.
I wonder if that should, one of this, one more item that I want to share with you. In regard to, I'm thinking in particular of the tennis court as part of that. This is, and I just kind of stumbled across this, this is actually a project dashboard that Phoenixville School District actually uses and they posted that they underwent a pretty major renovation program. And they post this dashboard on a monthly basis and show the project, and I really like this a lot. Mike and I started to have a conversation about this. We could select what pieces of information are put on this dashboard, but my vision for this would be to have a special physical website where there would be monthly updates. So this sheet would be kind of like a 10,000 foot view. You see in the center of the page, you could have two photos and then just a listing of what the overall work has been done. We can track the budget. We can see where budget to actuals are, requests for information, safety, motion reviews, quality reviews, when permits are issued, everything we put out in one place. This project, and I would encourage anyone who uses this website to take a look at it, because you actually have enough room and actually see where it started and where it ends. And based on the information, the dashboard changes, so you're able to track this project over time. The order action items in the upper right-hand corner, that changes based on how far you're getting through with the project. We could use something like this with the stellium too, is the other thing that I thought about. Let's start now with the tennis courts. It's a smaller scope of the project. Mike would be the point of contact with this and would be responsible for putting this information in here. Let's start with a smaller project so that we can be very transparent about what has been going on. The other thing that you'll see on the website is there are pictures that are uploaded weekly, and then along with this would be a weekly report on any other projects. But I mean, this could have some more discussion about the program, and some of these things may not be exactly what we want. But even the change order summary, I mean, certainly if there are any change orders that come about, we'll discuss them. But this way, it's very clear about what the costs are. I just thought that was great.
No matter what you do, how many times you can see, people say, no, you can see it. But I also learned this from archiving.
Absolutely.
I think it's really cool to see where we are, where we are.
So, I already went in that creative bathroom. So, because I liked it that much, and I think it makes a lot of sense. So, what I envision is the dashboard. There would also be accompanying photos that would be taken each week, so you actually see the weekly progress. And then there would be a prose or just a report of what's been done. Anticipated openings, if there have been delays, this building project is going on for a year and a half, so the snowstorms came in, that was part of that report. Due to the snow, construction was held up. But that way, we're just extremely transparent about everything we're doing with the projects. Mike would be the point person to, but he should be because of the weekly meetings.
That's it.
Good. Next meeting, August 1st, 8 AM. Lots of smiling faces. See you later. Oh, geez.